How strange it seems to say that one of my greatest pleasures is waiting for a train. The only pleasure greater is when it finally arrives and I get to get on board it. But this waiting is kind of like the eagerness, the anticipation, the desire, the need, all of those primal anxieties, all of those forces, those energies of need, of wish, of wanting, of desire, of I've got to have it. Oddly, it's akin to what I felt as a child when I got to go to Disneyland. I've got to go to Disneyland. And now, well, I've been there again today on the train from San Diego. A little bit late. I left San Diego at noon. Got here to this station about a little after 2, caught the bus over to Harbor Boulevard, and then lazy sat around and waited for another bus just to go half a mile, and then walked a quarter mile into the gate and spent most of the afternoon and the evening walking around and sitting down and looking at things. And I went on the train a couple times, and I went on the Mark Twain steamboat twice in a row. After everybody was unloading the first time, I said to the guy, "Can I go again?" And he said, "Well, if you want to." So I did. I went on the rockets, the ones that Skibby hates. Oh, I remember him saying, or maybe it was somebody else who said, but I think it was Skibby, he said, "I hated those rockets." I'm getting so fucking fat I could hardly get out of it. It was like I was stuck in the rocket. They're going to have to call paramedics and get the jaws of life to cut this obese blimp out of a rocket. No, but I did have to turn sideways. That's disgusting. Means I'm still gaining weight. I thought I'd stop that. It's time to weigh myself again and see how bad it really is. But you know, every other time I've had trouble getting in and out of those rockets because I am so big. 3 small people can ride in a rocket. 2 normal people. Oh my God. When I came with Terry a year and a half ago, we squeezed the 2 of us into the rocket. I thought I was gonna die. It was so squished. Well, by myself, what a wonderful ride. What a wonderful, wonderful ride going around and around and around and around. It was about 6 o'clock. The sun still up above the horizon, shining. Beautiful golden afternoon light. Around and around and around and around. I'm so big that I have to pull the throttle back with my foot. I just reach my foot down and pull it back. And up the rocket went and stayed up around and around and around and around. And I just watched everything go by. The Sleeping Beauty Castle, the Matterhorn Mountain, the buildings and towers of Tomorrowland, the restaurants around the Plaza Carnation House, the gates to Adventureland, the Frontierland Fort, and the Sleeping Beauty Castle and the Matterhorn Tomorrow, over and over and over. We must have gone around 10 times before they finally stopped the ride. It seemed a little bit longer, maybe not. Maybe I was just afraid that it would never end. Afraid because every minute I stayed in that rocket, I felt myself getting fatter and fatter. And then it was so hard to get out. I tried, I couldn't. I heard people starting to laugh. I turned sideways and slipped out. Oh, man. But anyhow, I'm waiting for the train. Once again, the last train of the night. Left the park at 9:45. And this time I walked all the way down to the bus stop on Catella. All the way down. 3/4 of a mile. This is supposed to be helping me, this exercise. It's a bribe. Go to Disneyland and exercise. I need to join the zoo again so I can go there once or twice a week. Especially now that summer's here and I won't be able to come to Disneyland. My pass is no good. It's the cheap pass, you know. Southern California Residents Select. It doesn't even cost $200. And I get into both parks free for 260 days of the year. Which means 100 days are no good. That's over 3 months. No weekends, no holidays. And 2.5 months of summer.
Everybody can come back inside to the station. The trains are running late. How late? I haven't got a boat. They struck a track plan. Going that way. That's what I said. 10:09 with a passenger. Yeah, going that way. So there, the train going south is held up.
Thank you.
No problem.
Well, the trains are running late. One, northbound train hit a trespasser, he said. And, whoa, what a little thrill. What a vicarious thrill. Somebody's corpus delicti is smeared all over the rails. Ugh, now it's making me shiver and shudder. Death on the train tracks. Well, the train's gonna be late. It's gonna be late, and it's gonna be late, and it's gonna be late. If I went into the train station, I could buy myself a soda. Pepsi or lemon lime or something from the machine. He came up and announced that in person. He walked up onto the platform and shouted it out. I don't know if you heard him, he was right down there. Which means that the loudspeakers aren't working. I noticed the electronic clock. There, you see that red glowing thing up there? It's frozen. It says Friday, May 11, 11:04 p.m. Well, it's wrong. Because it isn't Friday, and it isn't May 11th. It's Thursday, the 24th. I don't want to go inside, though. It's like, there's this chill, a little bit of a chill. You see what I've got? I got my shirt and my little coat. And it's like, you know, 58, 60. Nothing really cold, but kind of a sweetness to the chill. California weather. This close to the coast, it's always warmer in winter, just about this temperature. And it's always cooler in summer, just about this temperature. The problem with California weather is it's boring. You gotta get away from the ocean. Unless you like fog. If you love fog, hell, the ocean's a great place to be. And I do love fog. But if you want to get some real weather in California, you got to get away from the ocean. You get out in the Central Valley where Brian lives in Marysville. They get awful hot summers. Just baking like an oven. It's almost as bad as Death Valley, except it's not that dry because it's west of the Sierra Nevadas and there's rainfall all winter. And then the rivers are running. It's quite an agricultural wonderland. There's all kinds of crops they grow in the Central Valley. It's just huge agricultural empire. Orchards, ranches, farms. And especially around the Sacramento River Delta, they grow a lot of rice. They flood the fields and grow rice. But that's far north of here. Down here south, and I am in the greater megalopolis of Los Angeles here. Calangeles. This being Orange County, the southern end of the Great Basin. There's this vast flatland where the coast makes a big bend. It's like north of L.A., the coast bends to the west, and it actually runs to the west. And you get to the point of Santa Barbara, you're looking at the ocean, you're looking south, because the coast bends out. I mean, most people think of the west coast of North America runs north and south. Well, generally it does, but there are places where it makes a big bend, and this is one of them. And south of the bend, and west of the mountains, there's this basin and valleys. And the L.A. Basin runs for almost 100 miles, maybe 70. It's hard to measure it because there's also valleys, inland valleys. North side of L.A. is the famous The Valley. She's a valley girl, for sure, for sure. The Valley, also known as San Fernando Valley. Or, if you like, San Fernando Rey de España, which was the name of the mission that gave its name to the valley. So, you have this basin on the coast. Good grief, I'm running out of battery power. I was hoping to keep on talking until the train comes, but it's late. So I can't, and I won't. Yep. I'm gonna have to cut this off at 14 minutes. Because of the battery being so low and all. So, vloggerheads, another joy waiting for the train is dashed and smashed.